Hello friends, it's the beginning of the growing season. The season begins in September, but we've had rain almost through September. So since the last few days now we've had sun again. It's 1st October 2020 and I wanted to show you how the living room looks like when the season begins. It's a complete disaster. I'm not showing you all of it, but just let me show you what's going on in the growing area. You can see all my seedlings. Some of them still need to be transferred to individual cups. You can see over there. Some of them have already gone into their individual tall cups. Lots more. Some of them are from the germination test of the seed sale. And some of the seedlings here are the ones that I'm planning to grow in the current season. See the tomato stem trying to send out all these roots, and that is why the stem is always buried deeper upon every transplant, so that the plant has a very healthy root system. These have been transplanted into individual cups today. More seeds started there. You can see the disaster with the chili saplings, the ones that looked so good under the aquarium grow lights, and you can see that each and every one of them has got the curly leaf, and I have pinched off the tops and it just looks as though nothing will come back, but there is hope. I'll make a separate video to cover what I'm doing. Some of them have already gone into their grow bags. I'm using fabric pots for my chili plants over here. They're the exact same size as the pot that I used last time, but the fabric pots help to air prune the roots, and I've noticed that the plants do really well in that. The problem that I had was the potting mix dries out really fast. When I had grown, I think my red Gandhari was in a similar pot. So to counter that, what I've done is I've used the trays with good holding capacity. So once I water from top, I can put additional water here at the base, and hopefully that should work. And the other good thing that I like when the season begins is all my cacti come back from the other window into this space. There are cacti, euphorbias, aloes, agave, no succulents. Sorry succulents, there is no place for you in my garden because you don't do well. No other reason. I really like how the tomato saplings look at this stage. They're so gorgeous and pretty. And the cactus clump here. This section is one of my favorites. This is my first ever Sansevieria. It's a small variety. This is my favorite again. Euphorbia aeruginosa, really pretty. I have more stuff over here. Aloes. And this is the Ceylon spinach. It's been there for a while now. I think I showed it in an earlier video. And let me show you this. These are seedlings that have come up from seeds on their own in this. I forget the name of this one. Areocarpus. So there are two seedlings here, one and two. So once the plant flowers and drops its seeds, the seedlings come up easily. This is the black beauty tomato that I had shown in the video transplanting. Look at the root system. It's been 2 weeks since that video. I hope you can see this clearly. This is the advantage of a transparent cup. You can see the progress of the plant. Look at this beauty. I'll do a separate tour of all of these gorgeous plants. This is an old man cactus. Some of more Sansevieria. Another gorgeous aloe over here. Here is my lemon vine. It's been here for a while, and now that the sun is coming, it'll start to flower. A lot of work to be done, a lot of new projects and new ideas that I'm thinking of implementing this time. And I'll keep all of you posted. In the meanwhile, happy growing, everyone.